Hi, Vinay from V Competency Tech, and now we'll see the ternary operators. Ternary operators, and this we write using the question mark and colon symbol. So it has three part. First is the condition expression. The second part is the return value after this condition is true. It will return this value. If condition is false, it will return this value. So we'll take some example, like where result equal to 10 greater than 5. If yes, 10 is greater colon 5 is smaller, okay, something like that. And console dot right line result, okay. So this is the ternary operators. And the first part, condition is getting checked. If true, the second part gets returned. Otherwise, the third part. Okay, so it is not executing anything, just checking this condition and returning the value. Console dot. Okay. Let me run it. So 10 is greater, that is why the second part is returning. So we'll see how simple, how we can do. So for example, there is, I will write one integer a equal to 10, integer b equal to 100, and I will write integer c equal to, no, I will write boolean return equal to b greater than a. Okay, so this is the condition I'm assigning to one bool value, and this value I will write here. Okay, so this is the condition area. If this condition is true, this value will display. If this condition is false, this value will display. So I will give here, and I will give here like this. Okay, so we can assign value and we can assign the condition value itself, and that result also we can pass here. So this part contain the bool value, any boolean value. If I write here true, okay, if I write here true, means always this part will get executed. Okay, so it is true. Let's display this. I don't need right now. Okay, so let's run it. Let's see the output, what is coming. Okay, so it is true, means दिस एरिया कंटेन द बुलियन वैल्यू, दिस एरिया कंटेन एनी बुलियन वैल्यू, इफ आई गिव फॉल्स. ओके लेट्स सी. I will give here. It is false. Okay. So let's run it. Okay. So see how it is coming. Just wait for the output. Because I have given false, so the third part is executing. So it shows that whenever this part is giving boolean true, this value will come. If this part will give boolean false, this value will come. So that is what I am saying. If I give, let me take one condition, string name equal to, it is my country. Okay, if it is my country, if I give here name dot contain, okay, any kind of a condition we can give here which return the boolean value. Okay, so what it is giving, fine. So any boolean value, any kind of things we can give here which return the boolean value. So if country exists in this name, it is true will come. Okay, otherwise false will come. Let's run it. Let's wait for the output. It takes little time. Okay. So it's true. So because country exists here. So country exists here. So it is this is giving one boolean value. Okay. So always here what we want, any, this is boolean expression. Okay. Boolean expression. And this area is if it is true, which is true if this is true and if this is false. Okay, so always we need to give here one boolean condition. We can give 100 greater than 10, we can give 10 greater than 100, okay, anything we can give. So this is how we can write the ternary operator, and we use question marks and colon. Before question mark we need to give the boolean condition, boolean value. It may be condition or anything, but it should return the boolean value. If this value is true, the second part it will return. If value is false, the third part is return. Okay, so I'm done from my side. So if you like this video, please subscribe my channel V Competency Tech, and please don't forget to click on bell icon. Thank you.